your relationship, whether you are a man or a woman or a young woman or somebody who's married, we want you to know that God can heal that pain, that brokenness. God can heal the scars. God can make you brand new again. Have I got anybody in the house that when you look at the scars that you have, people didn't think that you would ever get over them, but God is a healer. He forgives us.
You know, we would be surprised at the number of people who sit in churches who are just toe up from the floor, just all messed up because they've been scarred by things in their life. And it's not just men or women. You know, children are just, you know, children are the first people to be messed up. Yeah. And if you don't get, let me just throw this in parenthetically, it's not even in the notes. But if you got stuff going on in your family and you don't get help from your children,
yeah,
your children will grow up jacked up.
Right.
And they're gonna be mean,
yeah,
and broken,
yeah,
and nasty,
yeah,
and violent. They're going to grow up with what they saw as a child. And they're going to take that into their adulthood. And they're going to be the same way that they were treated. So while you have a chance, get some help, get some healing, and let the Holy Spirit heal you. You don't have to carry these scars, man.
Amen.
He is the one who helps us through these things. Let me come quickly to the final part here. And that is the whole message of this life is that God raised Jesus Christ from the dead. That's it. That's the whole message of this life. That we proclaim that Jesus Christ is alive. We proclaim that God, that good does triumph over evil. Men crucified Jesus one Friday. But I'm glad that Sunday comes. I said, men crucified him on Friday. But Sunday came. And when they thought that they had gotten rid of the Lord of glory, God had another plan. You know, sometimes folks think that they've gotten over on you. Sometimes people mistreat you. And they feel like they've gotten away with it. But we serve a God who still sits, as Isaiah said, upon the circle of the earth, there's nothing that he does not see. And there's nothing that he does not hear. He sees all, and he knows all. He hears all, and he's able to do what we cannot do. You see, these men, they plotted against Jesus. They hounded and harassed him, and when they had him crucified, they thought that he was gone forever. And when they buried him in that tomb, the reverend says that they put guards in front of the tomb,
yes, sir,
and so that he wouldn't get out.
Yeah, yeah.
But just when people thought that they had closed every door,
well,
you know, God still opens doors.
Yes,
I said, just when folk thought they closed every door, God will open a new one. Is there anybody here that you work with some people who slammed the door on you and they put a lock on the door and said you will never get through in? But they didn't understand that we serve a God who can break through the death barrier. We serve a God who can open prison doors. And just when they thought that they had gotten rid of you, God has a way of bringing you through. Am I right about it? They put Jesus in the tomb, and they thought that it was all over. They didn't hear